game time.
Well, hey, this is our house. Why not set the tone early?
2-0 is the score. Mean Green here. That might be the fastest basket of the season. If you consult Doug Waters on that one, but Western Kentucky has it back the other way. Big three on the way. Off the mark, no good. But an offensive rebound by Pitts. And Pitts turns, fires, shot. Had too much on it, no good. And Johnson gets the rebound. Sends it back over here to Ariel Hardaway. We'll get you our First State Bank starting lineup in just a moment again. Just fighting through some technical problems today, so we have a abbreviated pregame show. As Ariel Hardaway loses control of it, it's on the floor. Both players dive for it. Hardaway comes away with it, got it to Johnson, who lost it, and then it goes out of bounds. Last touch, Western.
Mean Green basketball.
Well, we just saw right out of this Western Kentucky team what Jalen Mitchell meant by being a scrappy team. They're hustling after every single ball. And even if I'm their coach, I'm kind of happy with that hustle play. I know it didn't go in their direction, but your kids want the basketball.
Our Higginbotham Insurance quote of the game comes from Derman Jennings, who says Western Kentucky likes to make things look chaotic. That is how they win games. They just make it to a point where you can't really see much coming. This nice pass inside from Quincy Noble finds Anaya Johnson, and it's 4-0 Mean Green here early.
Johnson making it quick and known on this court that she is here to play. Tamisha Lampkin may be out, but I'm going to be that big man down low today.
Again, Western struggles a little bit when it comes to defending in the post, as now Hilltoppers trying to work it across into the front court. They barely do. Alexis Mead can't get free. There's a scramble for it. Mead running out of time. That's going to be a 5-second call on Western.
Fantastic trap right there. That's exactly where you want to get a small point guard who cannot see over your tall hands. The Mean Green did exactly what you want to do. You stand there with your hands straight up and just get in the way. 5-second call, beautiful. Great job not to foul.
Moore gets it inside or in play to Hardaway. Goes back to Moore. And Jocelyn Moore driving with it. Throws on the brakes at about the free throw line outside to Noble. 3 on the way. Got it. 7-0 Mean Green early.
And they're sharing the ball so well to start right now. The confidence is there.
Back the other way comes Western. High pass deflected, but it goes right to Hayes, who lays it up and lays it in. And the Hilltoppers, the Lady Toppers, as they're more known on the women's side of things, get their first bucket. 7-2 is the score with 8:09 to play here in the first. Back the other way comes Hardaway. She's stuck at the line, gets it up to Moore across the timeline. Back to Hardaway, across to Magruder, trying to get it. And Magruder's going to put up an NBA three, way too much on it. But the rebound goes right to Moore, who lays it up and in. And North Texas is 4 of 5 shooting to start this game.
Hey, if you want to get your points, crash that backside every time. The ball's going to fall right in your hands.
Hayes with it, gets a pass off. Stopping is Mead, puts up the shot well off to the left, but she gets her own rebound, tracks it down, works it over to Hayes. And Acacia Hayes now dribbling up towards the point and now kind of sets up between the point and the wing. It's a pass down low, but an offensive foul going to be called on Jalen Foster as she made contact with Anaya Johnson. Anaya Johnson, give her a lot of credit because she did not get a lot of playing time last year as a freshman. Had kind of been the backup to Tamisha Lampkin to start this season, but the coaching staff had enough confidence in her that they started her against FAU, and she responded well in that FAU game with 7 points and 10 boards and took 3 charges in that contest as well. Turnover this way for North Texas. Western gets it back up the floor. Home run pass to Pitts. Pitts driving inside, shot up good, and it's 9-4.
Key for the Mean Green to take care of the ball. They're doing better on those possessions where they settle in a little bit more, work that extra pass.
Magruder thought about a three but didn't take it. Instead gives it back to Hardaway up top, and she'll now call out signals with her left hand, dribbling with her right. Bounces it to Noble on the wing. Goes to Hardaway at the point. Magruder, wing three on the way. Got it to go. 5 of 6 for the Mean Green to start this game, including 2 of 2 from downtown. It's 12-4.
I mean, immediate redemption right there for that NBA three she jacked up a few minutes ago.
Alexis Mead with it back at the top of the key. Now dribbling, almost trapped, Hardaway. Now double team, Noble almost had a steal, works it across now to Hayes, who thought about a three but didn't take it, down just 8 to shoot. Hayes driving inside, and a foul going to be called here on the floor on the Mean Green. This will be on Kendall Magruder, her first personal first-team foul called on North Texas.
Great start for the Mean Green out of the box. I mean, taking care of that ball right out of the tip, it's just swung the momentum in their way from the start.
Alexis Mead with the inbound to Acacia Hayes. Three on the way, no good from Foster. Rebound fought for and won by Mead. Slings this one up high. They work it around to Pitts. Pitts puts up a three. That one had too much on it. Pitts fighting for her own rebound. Fell over, and it went to Magruder instead. And Magruder works it across the timeline. Finds Noble, gets it to Johnson. Comes down with it, lays it up, lays it in. And that is six first quarter points for Anaya Johnson. The Mean Green are up by 10. Foster with it. Works it into the front court for Pitts, who stops at the wing. Couple head fakes. Goes back up top to Foster, who finds Alexis Mead, the MLK High School product out of Moreno Valley, California. Driving inside. Slings it out to an open Meredith on the way, and Maya Meredith's three is good. And Western Kentucky needed that, 14-7.
That's the kind of player you want to have, the one that can just camp out in the corner, and you can count on her to just hit a shot for your team real quick.
It's now Hardaway with it. Started every game since the SMU game. They get it to Moore, slings it outside to Magruder. Another three on the way, too much on it. And this one going to be saved from going out of bounds by Maya Meredith. And she'll work it up to Mead, and a foul going to be called on Ariana Hardaway. That's her first personal second team foul on the Mean Green.
She kind of stopped her feet rather than continue to run alongside her there, and ref called that quick foul.
It's Alexis Mead back up the floor with it. Kicks this one to Hayes, and another foul going to be called on Hardaway. So two quick fouls on her, and Brianna Davis is going to check into this game.
She's almost just doing a quick little stutter step jump stop right when she meets the player, which is drawing that contact. And these players are smart. Like Jaylee Mitchell said, they're scrappy. They want to draw that contact and make the ref think, ooh, she might have just fouled her.
Hayes out of the inbound, finds Meredith, works it over to Hayes. Three on the way, off the mark, no good. And Brianna Davis gets the rebound. Davis working it up the floor, takes it across the timeline, slings it to an open Moore, who stops, now pivots over, turns and gives it back to Davis up top. Brianna Davis with it, 17 to shoot, left-handed pass to Johnson, but it's a little too low off her legs and out of bounds. And that will take us to our first timeout of the game. 4:41 to play here in the first quarter. 14-7 North Texas leads. This is Mean Green Basketball from Learfield. Perfect timing for this Mean Green, because you could tell that they needed that moment really quick to come back together, maybe get a little talking to by Jaylee Mitchell and just say, hey guys, we're right here in it. We're playing well. Keep it going. Pitts with it to Mead, that is Hayes rather, for Western Kentucky, dribbling just north of the far wing. Now steps up, drives into the paint, kicks a pass outside, 13 to shoot, slings it across, faking a three, 10 seconds to shoot, outside now to Foster. Foster dribbling inside, sends this one northward, three on the way, and good from Aaliyah Pitts. Back-to-back threes for Western Kentucky has trimmed what was a 10-point game down to just four. High pass over to Moore, who takes it into the front court, goes right up the middle. Nice little Euro step move for Jacqueline Moore, who lays it up and in.
Nice attack right there. The Mean Green are capitalizing on the lack of size inside.
Pitts trying to save it, but sent it right to Quincy Noble, who takes this one back up the floor for the Mean Green. Noble just going to attack the glass, and she lays it up and in. Man, North Texas just dominating in the paint right now. They lead 18-10.
If I was Jaylee Mitchell, I'd say let's just do that this whole game. That should be their game plan right now. This Western Kentucky team isn't doing anything to stop them.
Three on the way. That one's off the mark. No good, but an offensive rebound. Getting this one back up top. Slings it out. Another three on the way. That one short as well. But another offensive rebound by Foster, and the Hilltoppers can reset. It is Meade with it. Dribbling over, trying to get inside. Kicks it across to Pitts. Pitts with it, driving, puts up a shot that's blocked by Johnson, and it goes into the hands of Jacqueline Moore. Man, Anaya Johnson having a first quarter for her career. It is Magruder spinning inside, fading, bounces it out to Davis on the wing, holds it there, backing away from the defender Hayes, now trying to drive through traffic into the paint, outside to Moore, three on the way, that one's short, no good, rebound taken defensively by Meade, and then a foul going to be called on Anaya Johnson as she gets tangled up with the sophomore from Moreno Valley.
Just hanging out down there a little bit too long. If your team takes off to get back on defense, you probably should too as a big man.
2:43 to play here in the first quarter. Still an 18-10 North Texas lead. Mean Green have made five of their last seven field goals. They're shooting 73% as a whole in this game. And first quarters have not been kind to Western Kentucky this year. Just to give you an idea of how bad it was through their first seven games. As this pass goes outside, three on the way. That one's off the mark, no good, but an offensive rebound by Jaylen Foster. She'll hand this one off to Gilvin, who now gets this one to Meade across. Another NBA three on the way. That one's off the mark, no good. Another offensive rebound by Western Kentucky. Meade with it, puts up another three, and finally gets it to go.
Mean Green have to rebound if they want to stay in this game and ahead of this team.
18-13 is the score. Mean Green right now being out-rebounded by a 9-5 margin. In fact, Western has more offensive rebounds than the Mean Green have total rebounds, 7-5. But going back to the first quarter stat here, Michelle, the past four games in a row for Western Kentucky, they've outscored their opponents in the first quarter. The seven game, you include that, plus the seven games prior, so their entire schedule, they are still minus 58 on the season in first quarters this year.
Okay, so their head coach might not be fretting at all, Greg Collins. He might be like, all right, you know, first game back from the new year, and they're just reverting back to old ways. That's not something that is very enlightening to see as a coach, though, that's for sure. Now, he did make a big substitution change here on this court. We've got almost a whole new group.
Smattering of new players out there, and a couple substitutions as well for North Texas, as it's Jordan Carter with the basketball. Carter swinging this one to Moore. Moore trying to drive through, puts up a contested jumper, but knocks it down. Quick six points, for Jacqueline Moore, and it's 20-13.
She's got a really nice 4-6 foot jumper, and I'd like to see her pull it a little bit more. It's just the way it falls right in that net. She's really practiced it.
Kicks this one outside now to Meade. Meade almost lost it, has to turn back around, kicks it across to Savory. Savory, one of the new players out there, slings it across to Gilvin, three on the way. That one well short, and the rebound taken by Jasmine Bowles, who immediately hands it off to Jacqueline Moore. And Moore brings this one into the front court. Moore, little head fake, bounce pass up top to Davis, who will now set up the offense. Settling on the wing, gets it across to Moore, finds Noble on the far wing now. Dribbling down, losing control for a second, but gets it immediately to Bowles. Bowles fakes a pass to Davis. Bowles turning, still can't get it to Davis. Had it popped free, but she picks it back up. Six to shoot. Davis with it. Three to shoot. Davis driving, puts up a floater at the horn and knocks it down. Nice recovery there for North Texas, and they get points out of a very tough possession. Now back the other way comes Western. Works it to Blevins. Blevins lost it, but it bounced right to Foster, who immediately slings it over to Savory. Savory inside, shot up, no good. Noble gets the rebound. Quincy Noble trapped, but got it out to Davis, who brings this one to the front court, slings it to Moore, down low to Bowles. Bowles lost control of it, turns it to Carter, who lays it up and in. 24-13, Mean Green now on a 6-0 run over the last 90 seconds, and a foul going to be called here on Jordan Carter.
You had all five players touch the basketball for the Mean Green on that last offensive possession, and you could tell that movement was beautiful. The way that they saw, Western Kentucky has two players back because they got beat on a trap. Let's capitalize down here. That's basketball IQ, and that's a big improvement from this team, just kind of knowing and seeing where the bodies are on the court.
So 19.1 seconds left here in the first quarter. And free throws coming up, first one good. This is from Alexis Meade, who is an 84% free throw shooter on the year. First free throws for either team so far. Second attempt for Meade is on the way and off the mark, no good, but another offensive rebound by Gilvin. Goes up top, straightaway three on the way, short, no good. Rebound taken offensively, though, again by Gilvin, and she'll get it over to Savory. Slings this one up top to Meade. 8 seconds, down to seven, down to six, down to five. Meade with it. Goes corner for Savory. Savory, 2 seconds, down to one. Has to kick it up top. Shot right at the horn. Good! They'll review it probably, but for now, it's a good shot from Karis Allen, and they are going to review it. They're going to say a two. Thought it was a three at first, but they are going to look whether or not it was good, and we will tell you if it's good or not after this break. As it stands right now, 24-16 at the end of the first quarter. This is Mean Green Basketball from Learfield. Idea of Western Kentucky. They put up a lot of threes. They're ninth in the country in threes per game. They attempted 13 threes in that first quarter, made three of them.
You can tell Greg Collins is kind of rotating his outside guards based on that. Okay, let's see who's going to be on tonight. And that's why it looks like the lineup has changed so much since the start of the game.
Faustino with it, sends this one corner, shot on the way from Allen, in and out, no good, but an offensive rebound and a put-back foul call that will send Hope Savory to the free throw line, and you see there is the foul called on Jocelyn Moore, her first personal, first team foul. Just the, I really think Dermon Jennings, the assistant coach for the Mean Green, summed it up really well when it's just Western Kentucky plays a very chaotic game.
Yes, they do, and that's exactly what just happened, why you have to find your man when that shot goes up. You have to find a body, especially with this team. Otherwise, they are going to crash the boards. Moore was in the perfect spot to get that rebound, but she made no contact with anyone, didn't even see her coming.
First free throw attempt for the Louisville, Kentucky native Hope Savory is good, and she goes one of two, but another offensive rebound for Western Kentucky, and they can reset here, and then this one's going to be thrown away in a backcourt violation called on Western.
If I was Jaylee Mitchell, I'd really be getting onto my team right now, only because you are outmanning them on the free throw line, and they are still out-rebounding us off of free throws.
11 offensive rebounds for Western Kentucky. North Texas has 7 rebounds in total. And that's, you know, you want to narrow it down to one stat. It's obviously hard to do, but as far as rebounds go, that's been the win or loss for the Mean Green. They're 0-9 when they lose the rebounding battle, 3-0 when they win it. Magruder down low to Johnson, dribbling once, trying to get through traffic. Difficult shot, no good. Gets her own rebound, though. Puts it back and lays it in.
Fantastic post work right there. Just fundamental. You come in, you try to body your way in, make some space. Oh, the shot didn't go in. I'm going to go right back up. Didn't even bring the ball down.
Savory with it for Western. Sends this one over to Faustino. And Faustino with it, now backing up, being guarded by Moore, setting up at the point, slings this one over to Savory, 3 on the way, that one no good, a laser, but another offensive rebound. And this call is going to be on Brianna Davis. First personal, second team foul on the Mean Green.
Dermon Jennings seems to be feeling the same way I am right now. He's talking to the ref. Hey, why wasn't that an over-the-back foul? Because Brianna Davis did make contact and got low. She was reached over. I think that could have been an offensive foul there.
Back the other way now. Western trying to make something out of this second possession. 6 to shoot, 5 to shoot. Savory trying to get free on Davis. Throws up an awkward shot that falls through. And that makes it 26-20, 8:20 to play here in the second quarter.
She's really bodying her way in there, especially of her size. When you can really get in there, she's annoying Brianna Davis one, which is what you want to do to your defender all day.
Moore with it here for North Texas, setting up on the wing, slings a left-handed pass to Davis, who turns to Magruder, down low to Johnson. Johnson dribbling baseline, trying to get a pass outside to Noble, and it deflected off of a hilltopper and went out of bounds. So it'll stay with the Mean Green with 11 to shoot.
The Mean Green are switching between a 4-out, 1-in, and a 3-out, 2-in. But the 3-out, 2-in is what was really working for them early on, that two-man game inside. They have to pick who to guard. I'd like to see them go back to that.
Davis, 3 on the way. Short, no good. Rebound taken by Aaliyah Pitts, and Western will now take it back up the floor. It's Macy Blevins with it, getting it over to Faustino. And Faustino backing up here, being guarded by Magruder. Tried to set the screen on her, and since she goes right through, and an offensive foul charge taken by who else? Anaya Johnson, as Teresa Faustino picks up her first foul, first on the Hilltoppers this frame.
This team is scrappy. You can draw fouls from them like that all game. You just have to put yourself in that position. I think Brianna Davis is someone who needs to look and try to do that.
Davis bounced pass down low. Noble couldn't get a clean handle on it, and we're going to get a jump ball call as Johnson and Blevins both got possession there. And now Cortland Loudermill will check into the game as Moore comes out. It'll still be Mean Green ball here with 20 on the shot clock as they have the possession arrow. Noble looking, goes all the way up top to Davis, who comes down with it, slings it to Magruder. Bounce pass to Loudermill in the corner, holding onto it there, slings this one to Johnson, faking a shot, then lost it, and a foul call going to be made here on Western out of that mess. It's on Josie Gilvin, her first personal, second team foul on the Hilltoppers.
Not intentional, but definitely a hard trip right there. Johnson at the ground, and you could hear it in the gym.
Johnson with it, now up to Davis. Davis slings it. It's deflected, but goes right to Magruder. Magruder puts up a floater that's rejected by Allen, but it goes right back to Magruder, slings it out to Loudermill, but basically split the uprights between Loudermill and Johnson, and it goes out of bounds. And that'll hand it back to Western here with 7-11 to play in the second quarter. High pass to Gilvin, sends it back to Faustino. And the offense can set up here for Western Kentucky. Faustino working around defenders, going inside, slings it out, going to put up a three. It's on the way. Good from Maya Meredith. 26-23 now. The Mean Green lead has been trimmed as they have not scored in more than 2 minutes. Going to be Brianna Davis taking it up the floor. Bounce pass to Magruder. Back to Davis. Works it into the front court. Davis, left-handed pass to Loudermill in the corner. Loudermill looking for someone to get it to. Turns and threw it right to Faustino. And here comes Faustino back the other way for Western. Faustino threw everybody. Shot up good. And it's a one-point game, 26-25. 6:24 to play here in the second quarter.
This could be a good time for Jayla Mitchell to call a timeout and get her team to find some composure. They just, no one seems really like they want the ball in their hand, and they're not really making the defense move when they're playing offense. You want to keep moving.
Bad pass goes away, and it's stolen by Western Kentucky. It's Pitts. High pass went over everybody, and they're going to say deflected off of Noble, which is why it went over everybody. And now a host of substitutions made. Or is it going to be? PA said Mean Green ball, but it's Western ball. Thought it was Western ball. And it'll be Macy Blevins doing the inbounding here.
Looks like a whole lot of confusion down there.
Yeah, they're adjusting the shot clock now. They've taken 3 seconds off of it. So now 27 on the shot clock. There's the inbound. Three is on the way. No good. Rebound fought for and won by Gilvin offensively. Another offensive rebound. Another putback. Still would not go. Another offensive rebound by Pitts. Here's another three. No good. Quincy Noble is in some pain. And it goes out of bounds. Last touch. Western. Quincy Noble was basically doubled up underneath the basket. And he's going to try and fight through it and stay out there. But
it kind of looks like she might have got an elbow to the head on that big mess of all of them down low going after that ball.
15 offensive rebounds in this first half for Western Kentucky. It's Magruder trying to get around one defender. Goes across to Loudermill. Loudermill just going to put up a three ball. No good. Rebound taken defensively by Allen. And she'll work it over to Pitts. Pitts gets a pass off on the money to Blevins. Blevins shot up. No good. Anaya Johnson gets the defensive board and hands it off here to Magruder. Gets a pass over to Carter, who takes it across the timeline. Kicks it to Noble. Three on the way. A quick one. Off the mark. No good. But an offensive rebound by Magruder. Just going to put it right back up and knock it down. Kendall Magruder, 5 first half points for her. First points in more than 3 minutes and 40 seconds for North Texas, and it's 28-25 Mean Green.
A player who we weren't seeing her get a lot of minutes in this super pit, and now she's been playing really well for this team. Step back up into that position we know she can be in.
Here's a little floater on the way, and that one's good that time from Josie Gilvin. Yeah, on the topic of Magruder, she has hit double figures in three of her last 4 games scoring. So it's been probably the best 4-game stretch of basketball that Magruder's played in her career. And now a shot goes up from Carter that's no good, but she does draw a foul. And this will be on Karis Allen, her first personal 3rd Western team foul. And that'll take us to a timeout. 28-27 is the score. Mean Green lead by a point with 4:39 to play here in the second. This is Mean Green basketball from Learfield.
Erica C. on the court.
Thanks, Rob. All right, fans, it is now time for a t-shirt toss. Get on your feet and get loud for a t-shirt brought to you by First United Bank.
Thank you. all for Western this season, but they've gotten, if you look at the quarter-by-quarter scores, they get progressively better through each quarter, and the fourth is their best.
For the Mean Green, you just want to keep it up. I mean, they have only scored 4 points in this quarter, right? And so if I'm Jaylee Mitchell, I'm telling them, you guys got to do what you did at the beginning of this game. Let's start driving the lane. Let's start finding our bigs on the inside. Play that two-man game. I know Lampkin's not here, but I'd like to maybe see Johnson and Noble start that game that they are used to down low.
Some confusion now with the officials in the scorer's table. Tiffany Bridges, one of the officials talking to the scorer's table, whatever it was, has been cleared up, and now it'll be free throws here for Jordan Carter. First one, good. Carter's a 54% free throw shooter, the Temple College transfer by way of Austin, Texas. Played a lot in the last couple games, 26 minutes in each of the last two for Carter, as she drains both free throws here. Has really kind of gained the respect of Jaylee Mitchell for her defensive game, but she also can make a few baskets here and there.
That's what I was going to say. I really like Jordan Carter because she's a little motor. I mean, you see her. She's running. Those feet are going 50 miles an hour at all times.
Meredith with it. Gets a bounce pass down low to Foster. Goes up top to Pitts. Three on the way. Good. And that knots us up at 30 with 4:17 and counting here to play in the first half. Moore over to Magruder, takes it across the timeline, dribbling, gets it back to Moore, who's finds Magruder, now gets it front to Moore again, driving inside, outside to Loudermill, fake to three, trying to drive the baseline, but ran into a defender, goes to Moore, over to Magruder, pass outside to Carter. Jordan Carter slings it across to Moore, three on the way from Jocelyn Moore, too much on that one, no good, and the rebound taken by Foster. Here comes Western with it now. It's Alexis Meade with it, turning. Straightaway three from Foster. Too much, no good. And offensive rebound and a putback from Alexis Meade. And Western Kentucky has their first lead of the night at 32-30.
You never know. Alexis Meade is a sophomore. She plays like a senior on this team. She commands the court, and that's what you want from your point guard. But she goes after it at every level.
This one swatted away by Gilvin out of the hands of Carter, and Gilvin was able to chase it down. So a steal there for her. And the Western offense can set up, and there goes Meade again, dribbling inside, now works her way back outside again, and will switch hands, fakes left, drives right, kicks this one, a three on the way, and that one's off the mark, no good for Meredith, but another offensive rebound. Gilvin with it, outside to Pitts, this three on the way, still no good, another offensive board from Meredith, works it around, shot, three away, good. Alexis Meade with the triple. It's 35-30 Western Kentucky, and Jaylee Mitchell's got to take a timeout as Western's up to 18 offensive rebounds, just dominating the glass in North Texas' zone.
Good call on Jaylee Mitchell on this timeout. When that third Western Kentucky shot went up, her team didn't even try to find a man. They just stood there and watched, and she could tell, hey, these kids are tired, first of all. They just look tired. Second of all, no one's going after that ball. You got to get in their face. And that's one thing that Jaylee Mitchell does preach. Rebound, rebound, rebound. Especially with a team like this. We heard her say it. They're scrappy. You have to go after it. So great call on her to call a timeout. Recompose your team. Get them some water. And tell them, hey, we've got 2 minutes left in this quarter. That's it. Let's do this.
35-30, Western in front of North Texas again. Looking at the stats overall, this is a team that is fourth in the conference in offensive rebounding, Western is. They're a team that rebounds really well, and they are doing that so far, 23-11. They're out-rebounding North Texas. It's an 8-0 run right now for Western over the last 90 seconds, and again, just a dominating performance on the offensive glass for the Lady Toppers, 18 rebounds. 7 more than North Texas has overall. And now 2 minutes and 53 seconds here for North Texas to try and keep this one close or take the lead back heading into the locker room. It'll be Jordan Carter with the inbound to Brianna Davis. And Davis will work it to Carter, sends it back to Davis. Will now trot it across the timeline. Davis with it, dribbling. Trapped there in the corner, slings it to Magruder, across now to Carter. Carter with it, driving inside, gets it to Johnson, lays it up, lays it in. And that's 10 points in the first half for Anaya Johnson. It's 32-35 Western.
Beautiful dump. That's what you want to see. Go to the basket.
Alexis Mead with it. High pass down low. Shot goes up. Good. And a foul as Aaliyah Pitts gets the bucket and has a chance at a three-point play. Is picking up the foul is Jocelyn Moore, her second personal third Mean Green team foul.
We saw some really strong defense out of this Mean Green team right at the start of this game, and they've just kind of fallen off. And I get it. It's almost halftime. You're a little tired, but you got to keep playing hard.
It's a great first quarter for the Mean Green, 24 points. They outscored Western 24-17, but now they trail 38-32 as the three-point play is completed by the 57% free-throw shooter Aaliyah Pitts. 2:18 to play here before halftime. Magruder lost control of it but picks it back up off the floor, gets it to Carter, works it to Magruder, bounce pass down low to Johnson, turning, shot, foul. Going to be on Western Kentucky. I believe this is going to be on Pitts. Indeed it is. That's her first, and Anaya Johnson heads to the free throw line here to shoot two.
Johnson got that ball in the short corner, and you could tell she made eye contact with Jordan Carter, like, hey, cut the lane. And Jordan Carter's like, no, shoot that ball. And while it maybe might not have been the best shot, it did not make much air time or anything. Drawing that foul, I feel like Jordan Carter knew, hey, your man is right there on you. Draw that foul.
First free throw good from Johnson. She's a 67% free throw shooter on the year. It's trimmed it down to a five-point game, 38-33, and make it 38-34 as Johnson makes both. 12 first-half points for the sophomore from Red Oak High School. Now back the other way. Western has numbers. Faking a three is Pitts. Driving inside. Sends it up top to Meade. Slings it back over to Foster. Back to Meade. Across to Meredith. Three on the way. Off the mark. No good. Carter flying in to get the rebound. And gets it defensively. Slings this pass over to Davis, who comes down with it as we're under 2 minutes to play here before halftime. Davis backing up, calling out signals with her right hand, dribbling with her left. Now gets to Magruder, goes back to Davis. Over to Carter now. Carter dribbles, setting up on the wing. Finds it to Davis, across to Magruder. Eight to shoot. Magruder trying to drive inside, puts up a little floater and knocks it down. Kendall Magruder. Man, she has really improved her mid-range game lately, but a home run pass shot up good from Foster as Western got behind North Texas on that ensuing possession, and it's 40-36. Carter with the inbound to Magruder. Back to Carter again. Carter slings this one to Davis, almost collided with, but barely stands up. Now Davis driving through everybody. Davis slipping, gets it outside to Noble. Noble puts up a shot, knocks it down for Quincy Noble. 7 points for her, and it's back to a two-point game at 40-38. Final 55 seconds here to play before halftime.
You just want to play good, clean defense here.
Driving inside, or trying to drive inside, was Meade. Couldn't really find a lot of space. Instead, sends it back up top here. Trying to drive through is Meredith. Goes up to Pitts. Works it across now to Hayes on the wing. Hayes turning. Hayes outside. Five to shoot. Fighting through. Two on the way. Knocking it down is Maya Meredith. She's got 5 points here in the first half. Final 25 seconds to play. North Texas taking a little time to get it inbounded here. It's about 10 seconds come off the clock in that interim. Carter works it up to Magruder. Bounce pass back to Carter. Over to Davis. Shot clock is off. Final 13 seconds. Across to Magruder. Holds on to it there. 10 seconds. Bounces this one to Davis. 7. Down to 6. Down to 5. Davis with it. Throws on the brakes. Davis in trouble. 2 seconds outside to Carter. 3 at the horn. No good. And that will take us into the half. 42-38 is the score. The Mean Green had a lead in the first quarter, 24-17, as they make three of their last three, but Western counters with 4 of their last 5 to close out the half. And the Mean Green still very much in this game, but Western Kentucky had a much, much better second quarter. And again, those rebounds offensively for Western coming up big.
You know, at UNT, we've got a lot to be proud of, both academically and athletically. Lots of great moments, lots of great teams. But there's nothing that's more important than what these two men and their teammates and their coaches and the university and community did when they arrived on campus to play football at UNT. And we started going through and identifying the pillars of our strategic plan. We really wanted to highlight the things we're proud of. And so that's where the thought behind the Joe Green statue come about. The center point of that conversation was what would be an appropriate way to honor Abner, Leon, and their legacy. We talked about statues, we talked about plaques or, you know, memorials, but then really we wanted a place where people could gather. We had an alum named Joe Silva who had sent me a bronze bust of Joe, actually, when I first got here. And just said, hey, I, you know, I'm a Mean Green alum, love doing these bronze sculptures. Had some more conversations with him. Jared Mosley, I know, had conversations with him as well. And then Brandon Lacey, the campus designer, leads the design team, really come up with probably, initially it was somewhere between 10 and 20 concepts of a plaza. We wanted something that was really just a part of everyday life for people that would come in and out of our footprint. And the athletic center is that. Every student athlete walks by it every day. Every prospective student athlete walks by it. And so they understand the story and the significance. Our staff walks by it. So we hope it's a place where people feel comfortable hanging out, seeing the story, and really remembering a legacy that was incredible. You know, they're both very successful individuals, but they took much different paths. But really what ties them together is what they went through here in desegregating college football in Texas.
I never realized the impact that Abner and I coming to North Texas had on anyone. We drove up and met with Coach Otis Mitchell and asked if we could play a tryout for the team. And he said yes, but he didn't have any scholarships available, but if we made the team, he'd see what he could do. So we tried out, we made the team, and the rest is history.
Those were like great words coming from a great man and breaking down the barriers that had existed many, many years for segregation and integration.
Being accepted by the football team in itself was a big thing too. We were not only two blacks on the team, we were team.
It just gives you chills to understand that we had made such progress then. I feel like this is a continuation of something that began many, many years ago and many, many students ago.
I guess it was some 8 or 10 years later that it really hit me that we had made history at North Texas. It makes me feel good to know that hundreds of athletes will go by that plaza and see and read some of the accomplishments that I have made in life.
Thousands of athletes, student athletes of color at UNT have gotten new opportunities because of their courage and bravery. But thousands, tens of thousands across the state, in a time and place where there's so much energy spent on what our differences are and what divides us, an opportunity to talk about something that brings us together, I think is really impactful. People, both intentionally and unintentionally and even casually, get a chance to remember the legacy and remember the progress that was made here by those two individuals, by their teammates, by this community, and the impact that it's had on so many people. I think when you look back, the timing was perfect. They're at a point in their life where they're reflecting back, probably thinking about their legacy here and with their own family.
Can't be anything but excited for the day when you're a normal human being and you understand what human beings have sacrificed for many years, many hours, many days. You can't help but feel good about the positive approach.
I'm looking forward to seeing it because I'm going to be as surprised and as shocked as everyone else.
We've had so much support on this project. Mayor Hudspeth at the city's been incredible. He's mentioned to me probably a dozen times over the years, we really need to do something together, and they were a part of this project. And then President Smotrich, I mean, he's been a champion for athletics in many ways, for opportunities for all of our student athletes. But on this particular project, he was right there to support and to make sure we had all the resources that we needed. And so I'm grateful for President Smotrich as well and his support in getting this done.
if the young people coming later on in life can just look and say, hey, look what these two guys overcame, look what they achieved. If they can do it, I can do it. But to think that even when my life here is over, and people will be coming by, the legacy of Abner Haynes and Leon King will live and reign forever.
At UNT, we're just like every other university.
No, we're not.
You can be yourself at UNT. Be part of a Tier 1 research university. And get the best college food anywhere. UNT likes to have fun. With so many degrees to help you soar.
All in a caring community.
WKU is home for big dreamers. For those who shape the future, who set their sights high, accept challenges, fuel their passions. For those with the desire to create a better tomorrow. You don't come here to prepare for one thing. You come here to prepare for everything. You belong on this hill, where we engage, learn, grow, and celebrate together. Climb with us at Western Kentucky University.
Team during halftime. It should have been that, and I would think it would be that. Like I was saying, she's big on rebounding and getting after those boards. And the thing is I've been saying this all game, you know, she called this Western Kentucky team scrappy, and that's what they are, and you have to be scrappy right back when it's like that. You can tell, you know, if you take control of the tempo and don't let them, then you can really control the basketball here.
Western will have the ball to start off the second half, and it's Alexis Meade with it here for Western. Finds Jalen Foster back over to Meade. Gets it across to Meredith, trying to get free on Hardaway. Going to put up a very contested three, well short, and it goes out of bounds.
I don't know if you noticed that, but every single Mean Green player just found a body once that shot went up. So that just goes to show Jalen Mitchell had to say one thing to him, and that's what I'm glad she said.
There's your halftime adjustment as it's Kendall Magruder back up the floor. Just going to put up a floater off the mark. No good. Defensive rebound taken by Maya Meredith, who will sling it up to me. That's just the sixth defensive rebound of the game for Western. They send it down low and dribbling, losing control of it. It was Meredith, and it goes out of bounds. So back to North Texas. No points for either team yet here in the second half, 35 seconds into it.
Glad to see Ariana Hardaway back in the game. She picked up two early fouls, but she really does keep this team composed when she's in that point guard position.
Hardaway bounces it down low to Moore, slings it outside to Magruder, goes back over to Hardaway. Hardaway dribbling, trying to get through a defender. Instead finds Quincy Noble on the far wing. She'll go all the way across to Magruder, just going to put up a catch and shoot three that's off the mark, but an offensive rebound from Moore. Lost control of it. It's on the deck, and a fight for it, and the rebound going to be a jump ball call. It's Mean Green ball on the possession arrow.
Moore had the right idea going up there, but you just got to go up with a little bit more strength. That was like the strength of when you're shooting a floater, what just happened, and you're right under the basket. You got to make contact, be strong with that ball.
Noble with the inbound here to Hardaway, trying to drive inside, bounces this one to Anaya Johnson, turns, left-handed floater, knocks it down. Again, a career high, 12 points in the first half alone for Anaya Johnson. She's now got 14 off of that basket, looking great tonight. Alexis Meade with it, kicks this one over, three on the way. Everyone finds a body, but the three is up and good from Acacia Hayes, and it's 45-40 Western.
You just can't leave her wide open right there on the elbow. I mean, you could see that that's the kind of player that stands there and gets set at the three. So if you don't let her keep pressure on her, just play defense.
All the way across to a wide open Quincy Noble, three on the way, got it to go, and Quincy Noble for the 11th straight game has hit double figures. Driving inside, shot goes up, no good. Rebound taken by Noble, and she'll now work her way up the floor. Gets this one over to Magruder. Bounce pass to an open offensive foul called on Magruder. Trying to get it to an open Hardaway, but just a little too much that time for Magruder. She picks up her second first team foul, the half on the Mean Green.
She went down there too. I mean, it looked like her feet were almost taken out from under her. Just a tough play right there.
So still 45-43 is your score. Back up the floor comes Meade with it. Gets it to Meredith. Meredith still in the backcourt, now takes it into the front court and then lost control of it. It's stolen away by Magruder. Gets a high pass to Hardaway, who has to go chase it down. She does. Gets it to Johnson. Shot up and good for Anaya Johnson off the assist from Hardaway, and we're knotted up at 45.
Great feed right there, but especially great job of Hardaway to lead her player into a trap.
Driving, shot up, no good, foul called. And it's going to be on Jordan Carter. And it's going to be Carter's second. Second team foul in the Mean Green.
A lot of unhappy fans with that call, including what looks like Carter on the court. Like, hey, I don't know about that contact right there.
We'll send Aaliyah Pitts to the free throw line. She's a 57% free throw shooter and misses the first. Western now just 3 of 6 on the day from the stripe in what's been a pretty free throw list game. This is just the 11th between both teams, this upcoming one here for Pitts. And that one in and out, no good. Johnson gets the rebound, and then we get whistles and a foul on Western as Foster fouled Johnson. That's her second, first on Western this frame. And Green have made their last three baskets in a row. It's going to be Magruder, goes back to Hardaway. Hardaway bounces this one over to Magruder, who has it in the front court, now gets it to Noble. Noble tried to kind of underhand it to Johnson, who wasn't ready, and they get it back as Western Kentucky comes away with the steal. Kind of an awkward mess back the other way. Shot up, and a foul call going to be made here on Carter. And that draws the ire of the Super Pit. That is Carter's third team foul on the main green. And Carter's going to have to check out here as Jocelyn Moore comes back in, and that'll be free throws coming up here for Acacia Hayes.
A lot of frustration right there, but Western Kentucky knows what they're doing. They're going to continue to irritate this mean green team, first of all. Second of all, they're seeing these refs are just going to call these fouls down low. That's what we're going to do then. We're going to drive. I don't care that I'm a smaller size, but I know I can get to the free throw line.
1-2 on the free throws that time as Johnson gets the rebound. It's now 46-45 Western as Hardaway flying up the middle of the floor with this ball. Now stopping, turning outside to Magruder, faking a three. Gets a high pass down low to Johnson, who turns, lost it for a second, but picks it back up, gets it to Magruder. Bounce pass back to Johnson. Shot well short, but it goes right to Quincy Noble, who lays it up and in. Some great ball movement there from the mean green, and Quincy Noble able to kind of clean up the mess a little bit, and the mean green are up by one.
Aggressive attack by the mean green, too.
Back the other way. Shot up off the brim. No good. Rebound taken by Jocelyn Moore. And now Moore works her way up the floor. 2-on-2. Moore driving inside. Shot no good, but a foul called here on Maya Meredith. It's her first personal second team foul on the Hilltoppers.
Good little take right there. Now you got to make these free throws count. She made a good choice right there. I don't know what I would have done with those two girls right under the basket. I might have looked to pass it out, but to draw that foul and still maintain possession of the ball, pretty good job right there by Moore.
First free throw, too much on it. Moore is a 73% free throw shooter. That is the first miss of the day from the line for the Mean Green, who were 4-of-4 to start this game. Second attempt from Moore. That one is good. Nothing but net. And it gives North Texas a two-point lead with 6:37 to play in the third quarter, 48-46. Western into the front court with it. Couple fakes from Hayes. Goes across to Foster, being guarded by Moore. Stopping, kicks this one to an open Hayes. Three on the way, no good. Rebound taken by Hardaway. Gets a home run pass over everyone's head, but Moore chases it down, lays it up, lays it in. Jocelyn Moore with 9 points now in this contest. It's 50-46. North Texas, their biggest lead since they were up by 11. Here's another three on the way. That one good from Acacia Hayes. And just when you think you've got some momentum, Western Kentucky does something back the other way to draw it away.
You just got to keep it going right back at them. That's the kind of game they play. You have to shove it back and down each other's throats, and it's the best team on top at the end.
Moore got a pass to Hardaway, and Hardaway will shift into gear, drives right up the middle, kicks it back to Moore. Moore just going to put up a three. That one no good. Rebound taken by Maya Meredith. She'll sling it over to Alexis Mead, who brings it into the front court, and Western down by one, trying to take the lead back. Here's another three on the way. That one good. Back-to-back threes from Western. Jalen Foster knocks down that one. She's got five, and it's 52-50. Western Kentucky on a 6-0 run. Back-to-back threes in 38 seconds. Hardaway to Moore. Drives up, pass over to Johnson, who draws a foul. This one's going to be on Jalen Foster, and she picks up her third, their leading scorer. And a couple substitutions made as heading to the free throw line will be Anaya Johnson.
Really admired how Anaya Johnson has come into this game today. Now, she didn't have great position underneath the basket, but she knew that she had to go up strong. She's playing with a very high IQ for a post player, especially for not having played very many minutes before this.
Johnson's first free throw is good. She's got 17 points, making a strong case for our Raising Cane's player of the game. If she can hang on here, she's four rebounds shy of what would be her first career double-double. Knocks down both there. She's a perfect 4-for-4 from the stripe today. Perfect 3 for 3. Nope, 4 for 4. Excuse me. She's got 18 points in this contest. Corner. 3 on the way. No good. And offensive rebound put back good from Karis Allen. And Western Kentucky, Michelle, if they get an offensive rebound, that's another thing, too. They don't waste any time. They just put it right back up.
No, and that's kind of what you have to do. You don't even bring the ball right back down. You can't give them a chance to defend.
Noble from 3 gives the Mean Green the lead right back as we toggle back and forth here at the Super Pit. 55-54, Quincy Noble now with 15 points to go along with 3 rebounds, 2 assists, and a steal. It's going to be Faustino bringing this one up the floor here for Western. Gets around Magruder, driving inside. Shot goes up, good, and Western's got the lead back by a point at 56-55.
Quincy Noble really liking that left-hand corner this quarter.
Magruder to Hardaway, who takes it across the midcourt stripe. Magruder back to Hardaway, almost lost control of it, and a backcourt violation. I thought they might have ruled a deflection.
Yeah, but that's not really a call you can make when the last.
Haley Mitchell getting the explanation right now from the official Julie Krummenhock. And Jay Lee does not like whatever explanation she got, but no change forthcoming. It's 56-55 Western Kentucky with 4:06 to play in the third quarter. This is Mean Green Basketball from Learfield. Western Kentucky has hit 10 threes in this game and is still just, not really dominating rebounds anymore. It's 26-21. North Texas has done a much better job rebounding here in the second half. Back the other way comes Western Kentucky. It's going to be Gilvin. Slings this to Hayes. Hayes being guarded closely by Noble. Hayes trying to dribble free. Noble staying right with her. Gets it to Pitts on the wing, thinking about a three, but didn't take it. Just 5 to shoot. Faking another three is Hayes, driving inside through everybody. Blocked away by Johnson. Offensive foul called as well on Acacia Hayes. I don't know if that was a block or a foul or which happened first or who will get credit for what, but it'll be Mean Green Ball nonetheless.
I'm not really sure what happened there either. I don't know if it was a foul on anyone per se there, but also if the refs are trying to do the Mean Green a favor, that would be nice after the last couple goals.
This is one to Magruder. Now finds Hardaway. Holds onto it there. Goes back to Magruder on the wing. Goes back to Hardaway up top. Dribbling right-handed. Now shifts to her left. Tries to bounce this one over to Magruder. Fake to 3. Driving through. She's triple-teamed. Gets it to an open Johnson. Johnson lays it up. Lays it in. Anaya Johnson with 20 points on 8 of 10 shooting. What a night for the sophomore.
Just a kid in the candy store down low right now. She's picking out all the gum pulls.
Pitts with it back the other way, and an offensive foul called again on Pitts.
Textbook take right there by Ariana Hardaway. She set her feet, and you saw the collision move through her body as she fell to the ground. Fantastic fundamental play.
57-56, North Texas in front. Neither team has led by more than 2 in a long time. 2:53 to play here in the third quarter. It's going to be Jocelyn Moore taking this one into the front court, just driving inside, slings it out to Noble, fake to three, goes baseline, trying to get a pass over to Johnson, but instead it's going to be taken away here by Hayes, and Noble going to get called back the other way. Noble protesting that an arm was thrown at her, but no call forthcoming. First on Quincy, fourth on the Mean Green here this quarter.
She just didn't get her hands up early enough. There was a little bit of tangledness right there, and it was quick. I mean, that was a quick call, but if the refs are going to call the game like that, you got to play really careful on defense.
Pitts with it, holding it up top. Now gets it over to Hayes, being guarded by Noble there, slings it down low to Allen. Allen just going to turn, put up a long two. That one's off the mark, no good. And Hardaway gets the defensive rebound now here for North Texas, and Hardaway double-teamed, trying to dribble out of the trap, looking. Got 4 seconds to get it across, finds Moore, but it hit her hand and then went right to Karis Allen. Gets a bounce pass down low to Pitts, lays it up, no good. Fight for the rebound is won by nobody. Off on Aya Johnson and out of bounds. It'll stay with Western Kentucky with 20, fresh 20 on the shot clock, 2:05 to play here in the third quarter.
Kind of an ugly series right there. If I'm Jaylee Mitchell, I'm telling my team, breathe. Everyone, calm down. Let's stay composed. We're playing well. We want to stay in this game. You got to possess the ball.
Western has not made a basket in 2:17. They miss a three there, and then a foul going to be called on Western on Odie Betancourt. That's her first personal, and North Texas is in the bonus. So this will result in free throws here, I believe, for Quincy Noble.
Nice little over-the-back call. Quincy Noble did a good job of getting in between her man and the basket. You get low right there, and you'll get that call.
Noble, a 83% free throw shooter, second best on the team, only to Kendall Magruder. Makes the first, and Noble's got 16 on 6 of 7 shooting today, 3 of 4 from downtown. Noble makes it a three-point game at 59-56 with 2:02 to play here in the third. It'll be Meade. Taking it across the midcourt stripe, being guarded by Hardaway. Hands the ball off to Hayes, who's trapped there. Kind of dribbles out of it, though. Now trying to drive right up through the middle. Shot up, no good. And Anaya Johnson gets the rebound. Hands it off to Kendall Magruder. High pass to Moore. Comes down with it. Almost traveled. Just puts up a jumper. Rolls across the rim. Sat on the rim. Would not fall on the rebound taken by Betancourt. We'll get this one over to Meade. And Meade will trot it up the floor, being guarded closely by Hardaway. Meade, dribbling, driving, now stopping, gets this one out to Betancourt, across to Hayes, another three on the way. That one's off the mark, no good. Moore trying to fight for it, but an offensive rebound by Gilvin, and they can reset here, Western does. Here's a two on the way from Betancourt, off the mark, no good. Another offensive rebound taken by Meade. Straight away, three, drains it. 11 three-pointers in this game for Western Kentucky, and we're knotted up at 59.
You have to possess the ball, and it's not just those rebounds, but it's capitalizing on these offensive possessions as well, working a good shot and not rushing something really quick like we did a second ago.
Western, that was their first make in their last 7 shot attempts, as now Kendall Magruder draws a foul back the other way, and she'll head to the free throw line. The call is on Karis Allen, her second personal. And Kendall Magruder, who is probably one of her biggest improvements this year, really I'd count two, her mid-range game and shooting free throws.
So really about that confidence that you can tell she grew into. I mean, she is playing like an older player compared to how she played at the beginning of the season, and that's just kind of finding your footing on a new team where you're not sure where you stand yet.
Both free throws good there for Kendall Magruder, who's got 9 points in this contest. It's 61-59 North Texas. Meade just weaving through everybody. Slings it up top. This one held on to by Allen, and now she'll dribble over. Hands it off to Hayes. Final 30 seconds here in the third quarter. Hayes trying to get around Hardaway and barely does. Now runs into Noble, goes up top to Allen. 3 on the way. That one's short, but an offensive rebound put back, blocked by Johnson, but it goes right to her again. And Western sets up with 15 seconds left here. Shot clock is off, and Meade is going to hold it for the last shot. 10 seconds to play in the third quarter. Meade with a little double fake. Step back jumper, short. Quincy Noble gets the rebound, 4 seconds left. Noble slings it forward to Moore. Moore lost control of it, and it goes out of bounds with 0.3 seconds to play.
Man, and what an opportunity right there before the end of the quarter. That's really what you wanted. It would have really sealed the momentum going into the fourth quarter, but nonetheless, great job at the Mean Green of not allowing a shot, at least, at that last couple 30 seconds from Western Kentucky.
So, fourth and final frame coming up. It's 61-59, Mean Green lead. This is North Texas basketball from...
Saturday, January 7th at 3:30 p.m. when the Mean Green take on the Blue Raiders of Middle Tennessee. Again, game time set for 3:30. And be sure to come out for our next home men's basketball game on January 11th as the men take on Louisiana Tech. Game time set for 7 p.m.
Continue, especially in this fourth quarter, because the score is basically 0-0 right now.
Again, this is a Western team that takes a lot of threes. They're ninth in the nation in three attempts. They have attempted 34 threes in this game and have gotten 11 to fall. It's going to be Gilvin with it and then turned over and stolen by Hardaway. Hardaway around defenders, dribbling with it, kind of lost control for a second, so she had to peel off. Gets it to Johnson. Johnson pivoting, shot up, no good, but a foul called. And Anaya Johnson will likely head to the free throw line.
She's just making moves down low all day long. Either side, too. She's become one of those post players that can just turn and have that ball high and find the basket. And that is the ideal post player. And it's really exciting to see her starting to come into herself right now. I mean, heck, it's right at the beginning of January.
No Tamisha Lampkin.
Is going to continue to grow, you know.
You know, in the place of, and that's another thing, too, is you know this coaching staff has confidence in her. First shot up is good from Johnson. That gives her 21 points. Before Tamisha got injured against FAU, they inserted Johnson into the starting lineup ahead of Lampkin. As the second free throw's off the mark, no good, but then we get whistles and a foul call on Western. This is going to be on Pitts, and Pitts has picked up her third, second team foul on Western. But back to Johnson. Again, even before Lampkin got injured, Lampkin's still obviously a big part of the down low game for the Mean Green, but that just shows the trust this coaching staff has in Johnson to say, hey, we're going to put you in the lineup to try and shake things up. Three on the way from Noble, no good. And Western comes back up the floor.
Well, it's a good move as a coaching staff because it instills that confidence in that player, and then they really will start playing their best basketball under you.
Meade being guarded here by Magruder. Gets it over to Foster, back to Meade. Holds onto it there, Meade, with that high-powered motor. Kicks it outside to Gilvin, who faked a three, drives inside, trying to get an awkward pass off that wasn't really ready, and Carter steals it away, and she'll get it to Magruder. And here comes North Texas up the floor. Kendall Magruder, bounce pass to Noble. Noble right up the middle, throws on the brakes, off the glass, no good. Rebound taken by Pitts, and she'll get it to Meade, and Meade flies up the floor. Meade outside to Foster. Thought about a three, didn't take it. Said scoops it over to Meade. Three on the way, no good. Rebound fought for and won by Hardaway. Then it's off the shoe of Johnson and goes right to Western. They'll set it back up. Corner for Savory. Three on the way, good. And Western Kentucky just taking advantage of every second chance opportunity they can. It's knotted up at 62. And now we get whistles, and I think there's a wet spot on the floor that they're going to have to clean up here.
This Western Kentucky team, you can tell they're coached very, very well. I mean, they hustle after every single ball, and you can tell Greg Collins makes some subs the minute a kid is not hustling. And that really, when that's your biggest thing on your team, then you're going to have just this high motor, well-conditioned team that can play a full 40 minutes.
Hardaway gets out of the trap, gets it to Carter, who will bring it up towards the front court. Now gets it into the front court. Carter looking. It's a high pass to Moore, who comes down with it. Slings it to Hardaway, immediately pressured. Now driving inside, gets a floater to Johnson. Comes down with the pass, lays it up and in. 23 points for Anaya Johnson at 64-62.
And that's what Ariana Hardaway does best, and that's what makes her such a great point guard. Now, she's not scoring anything. I mean, she hasn't scored anything this game, but she sees the open player. She knows what's working for her team on any given night and says, okay, I'm going to feed that, and I'm going to get points on the board. It just may not come from my hand directly.
Straightaway three is off the mark, and Carter flying up for the rebound, comes down with it, then tries to turn out of it, and a jump ball call going to be made here. Possession arrow is with North Texas.
Jordan Carter almost got the ball stripped from her hands. A little bit of a reminder to her down there. Hey, this team is going to come after it. I better hold on tight.
Carter in this game, that's just her second rebound. In this contest, a couple subs being made here for Western Kentucky, and now it'll be North Texas ball up by two, 7:36 to play. Magruder to Davis, who's in the game now. Back to Magruder, back to Davis at the point. Davis trying to dribble free, lost it for a second, but bounces this one to Moore. Moore trying to turn, gets it up top to Davis, across to Magruder. Three-pointer on the way, in and out, no good, but Moore with the offensive rebound, lays it up, lays it in. Jocelyn Moore, double figures for her, 11 points on 5 of 11 shooting, also a free throw in the mix as well, and it's 66-62 Mean Green.
That's how you make your possessions count. You get that second chance point, and you make it.
Back the other way, Gilvin dribbling, trying to get around Moore. Slings it outside to Savory, being guarded by Carter. Savory spinning, trying to get around Carter. Blocked out of bounds by Jordan Carter.
Great job by Jordan Carter. She's getting really frustrated with those foul calls earlier, and you know that's what she was trying to do all night. Just get that nice little tip as they're running by.
Quick inbound here to Faustino. Gets it over to Savory. Slings it up top. Western trying to set up a play here. It's Savory with it. Two to shoot. One to shoot. Shot goes up at the horn, and it is no good. And the rebound taken by Moore. And then a call, foul call on North Texas. This is going to be on Magruder. That's her third first foul call on North Texas. And that's a big break there for Western, as they'll take it over.
You can't really be mad at your player there. I mean, Kendall Magruder is just blocking out, got called on the hook.
Three on the way from Faustino and knocks it down, and it's a one-point game. Again, just when you think you got a little bit of space brewing, Western comes back with a three, and it's now a one-point game. Jordan Carter dribbling behind her back, coming away with it. Still 6:24 to play here. A lot of basketball left. It's Kendall Magruder. Slings it to Moore. Moore through traffic. Shot up and no good. Took a couple awkward hops, and the rebound taken by Faustino. And here comes Western up the floor, trying to take the lead back. Outside to Savory. Three on the way. No good, but an offensive rebound. Immediate putback. Still would not go, and Anaya Johnson gets the rebound, her eighth of the game. Moore turned it over, stolen away by Pitts, and now waits for the rest of her teammates to come back so they can set something up. Faustino with it, a couple substitutions coming here for North Texas as Ariana Hardaway and Quincy Noble head to the scorer's table. Faustino with it, trying to drive inside, kicks this one out, contested three on the way, off the mark, no good. Johnson flying in, comes away with the rebound, and a foul call made here on Western Kentucky. It's going to be on Hope Savory, her first personal, third team foul on the Lady Toppers, as now Moore and Davis check out, Hardaway and Noble check in.
You know, something this Mean Green team tends to struggle with is those lackadaisical passes that get picked off, especially at a time like this where Western Kentucky is full court pressing. They want that ball more than anything right now.
And another turnover as Hardaway gave it up. 2-on-1 back the other way. Pass to Savory. Shot up off the high glass. No good. And getting the rebound is Noble. Still couldn't get a clean hand on it. And it pops right to Carter, who now runs it up the floor. Carter with it. Driving inside. Shot goes up. No good. Scramble for the rebound. Won by Faustino for Western Kentucky. One-handed pass into the front court for Savory. They work it down low. Shot goes up. No good. And a fight for the rebound is won by nobody. It's on the floor. And a jump ball going to be called. Hope Savory thought she had full possession of it. Either way, Western will get the ball because they have the possession arrow. But a big kerfuffle at the top of the key.
Huge hustle by Jordan Carter. I mean, she hit the ground the minute that ball went to the ground, and thank God she did because she was the only Mean Green player that did. All the other Mean Green players, aside from Anaya Johnson, who came in a little late, just kind of stood and watched, and you got to make every possession counts, and that means these jump balls. It's anyone's ball.
Faustino lays it up and lays it in, and it's a Western Kentucky lead at 67-66 here as we roll into the halfway mark of the fourth quarter. Mean Green have not scored in more than 2.5 minutes. Kendall Magruder with it. Holding on to the basketball. Now driving left through traffic. Puts up a fadeaway floater. Had too much on it, but Noble gets the rebound. Shot off the glass and knocking it down is Quincy Noble. 19 points for her, and the Mean Green retake the lead at 68-67. Back up the floor, almost poked free by Faustino. Carter still trying to poke it free, and it went out of bounds off of Faustino. And it goes back to the Mean Green, and that will take us to our final media timeout, 68-67. We got a good one brewing at the Super Pit. Mean Green in front with 4:22 to play. This is North Texas basketball from Learfield. And they'll have the ball here out of this timeout. It's going to be Hardaway. High pass to Carter. Had to jump to get it, but comes down with it. Now dribbles over. Finds across. Magruder faked a shot. Driving. No look pass to Noble. Three on the way. Got it. Quincy Noble.
And I might have said this a few minutes ago. I might have. I did. That left-hand corner tonight, Quincy Noble, that is her spot, man.
71-67, 3:55 to play here. It's Maya Meredith with it, trying to drive inside on Johnson. Offensive foul called on Meredith. Her second personal, fourth team foul on Western Kentucky, and that'll give it back to the Mean Green, a four-point lead with 3:49 to play.
Just what you want coming out of that timeout, man. Immediate shift in tempo towards the Mean Green, and you want to keep it that way.
Jordan Carter with it back up the floor. Gets this one over to Magruder goes back to Carter, back to Magruder, into the corner for Noble. Hardaway almost had it stolen away, but comes up with it. Magruder straight away, NBA three! Kendall Magruder! 74-67! Timeout, Western Kentucky!
I mean, I could have told you that timeout was coming. This team, they just swung the whole game their way, and that's what you want to keep up. Don't let this timeout get in your head.
We will take one last timeout. 74-67 is your score. Mean Green with back-to-back.
Fans, on your feet, make some noise if you want to catch a Mean Green t-shirt.
Clock. You can't let Greg Collins coach's team up too much right now.
All Western is a couple three-pointers away from getting right back in this game, and there's a two from Jalen Foster to make it 74-69, so back down to a five-point game. It's going to be Hardaway with it into the front court, dribbling over, holding there, backing up. Mean Green trying to milk a little bit of the clock here as we roll under three to play in this game. Hardaway slings it to an open Anaya Johnson, who lays it up and in. 25 points for Anaya Johnson at 76-69.
I mean, the read right there. Josie Gilvin just left her player, left Johnson completely. Ariana Hardaway saw that. That cut to the basket. Textbook basketball.
Three on the way from Western. That one's off the mark. No good. Flying in, getting an offensive rebound was Foster. They'll work it up. Kicks this one over. Pitts driving inside. Puts up a floater. Knocks it down.
That's what I'm saying, Zach. Back and forth this entire game. That's how it's going to be these last few minutes. But if you're the Mean Green, you just want to stay ahead and make the most of every single possession.
76-71. Hardaway trying to drive inside. Hardaway's going to go for her first points of the game. Just a little too much on it. And the rebound taken defensively by Pitts. Gets this one to Meade, who takes it across the timeline. Pointing out directions. 2 minutes to play. Five-point game. 76-71. Step back, travel. Meade took an extra step on that three attempt. I think she was trying to get behind the three-point line, realized she was just in front of it, and then that caused her to take the extra step.
Western Kentucky losing a little bit of their composure, but Meade is such a good leader. I mean, she keeps clapping her team up like, hey, guys, that's okay. We're still in this, and that's what you want out of your point guard.
Magruder.
She's a good leader.
Magruder with it, trying to get around Foster. Magruder through everybody, shot up no good, but draws the foul.
Man, and I really thought that one was going to fall. I mean, it was high on the glass, but I thought, man, she's got it. She's got it. Would have been a nice three-point play for Kendall Magruder for sure.
The foul is on Jalen Foster in the leading scorer, at least as far as season averages go, not in this game. Foster has her fourth foul. That's the fifth team foul on the Hilltoppers, so North Texas will be in the bonus for the final 1:43 of this game, leading by five. First free throw on the way, in and out for Kendall Magruder. It's her first miss from the stripe in this game.
These free throws matter.
Second attempt for Magruder. Big one there, nothing but net, 77-71. 6-point game. 1:43 to play. North Texas trying to hang on. Foster with the inbound. Mean Green putting on a little bit of defensive pressure in the backcourt, but Hayes will trot it easily into the front court and will set up the offense here for Western. And a six-point contest, 90 seconds to play. It's Hayes with it, turns it around to Pitts. Pitts driving inside, kicks it out. Straightaway three on the way, no good. And Carter gets the rebound, dribbles through a trap, throws on the brakes, and gets it back to Magruder, who will work it into the front court here. Magruder to Hardaway, immediately double-teamed. Back to Magruder. She's got a wide-open three, but wisely waits to drain some clock. Smart play there by Kendall Magruder to let this clock continue to drain here with a six-point differential. Hardaway lost it but picks it back up. She had a lane, come away with it, botched the layup, and an offensive rebound for Anaya Johnson. That's a double-double for the sophomore.
Man, she's making every possession count when the ball touches her hands.
All the way across, faking a three is Pitts. Pitts trying to get inside. Pitts shot blocked by Noble. Goes to Magruder, dribbles out of a trap, throws it to Johnson, and a foul called on Western Kentucky. It's on Aaliyah Pitts, her fourth, and free throws coming up here for Anaya Johnson, who's got 27. Or excuse me, it's going to be Magruder taking the free throws, but still, first career double-double for Anaya Johnson, 27 and 10. What a game for her.
What a game for her. But something I really, really want to point out, and it's just growth you can see from this entire team. The last time we saw this team in this gym, they would not have known to pull the ball out with a minute 10 when you have this lead. They wouldn't have. And that's just where they were at as a team. They didn't see the clock. They didn't see the players. And now you didn't even have to hear Jaylee Mitchell tell them, hey, do not take that shot, Kendall. Pull it out. You could tell they've really grown as a team and in their system.
Magruder goes 1-for-2 from the stripe. It's a 9-point Mean Green lead. And a timeout taken by Western Kentucky, just a 30-second timeout, 40.4 seconds to play here. And, you know, in the midst of this, looking at all the scores for the Mean Green, Anaya Johnson, who before this game, her career high was 10, has 27 tonight, almost overshadowing two great performances, Quincy Noble with 22 and Kendall Magruder with 14.
Well, you know what? On a team like this, you have to have a point spread across the board like that. And when players are playing like this, it's not just Quincy Noble gets in the double figures and then someone maybe gets to 9 or 10 usually. Having players at 22, 14, and 27 on this team isn't common, and it's exactly what they need to win games.
It'll be Western Kentucky basketball here, 40 seconds to play. Quick inbound, they need fast buckets. Here's a three on the way, short, no good. Rebound, last touch, North Texas. Mean Green actually, you know, going back, to Michelle, to what you were saying, stats aren't wanting to cooperate with us, but a timeout taken by the Hilltoppers. Four players in double figures. Jocelyn Moore quietly with 11 tonight as well.
Very quietly. She kind of started off the game really strong, and her shot hasn't been falling as much in this fourth quarter. You can see she hasn't been in the game as much. But right there at the beginning, I mean, she was hot from that 4 to 6 foot range, and she's got a really pretty shot there. That's something that she can continue to work on. But having the pull-up jumper like she does is something that is really key for this team. She brings something good to the floor when she is on.
So 35.4 seconds left. It's still a 9-point Mean Green advantage. It'll be Western ball out of this 30-second timeout with 26 on the shot clock. And I think they're actually going to review this to see who the last touch was for.
See, if I'm Jaylee Mitchell in this timeout right now, I'm just telling my team, when you get out there, you play good, clean defense. If you don't foul, then they cannot score 9 points in 35 seconds. As long as you take care of that basketball and play good, clean defense, that's all you can do. Rebound the ball.
They are consulting Toronto about who touched that ball last before it went out of bounds. We'll see if they reverse their call or not. So this is going to lead to an extended timeout as they continue to look at the video board. We'll get a look at the replay here ourselves. That is mighty close, but I think it's Western ball. I think Quincy Noble barely touched it last.
I would like to see the other angle as well from the other side. Like, can we have the NBA in here shooting this game for us?
It was almost like they touched it simultaneously. And we can see on the monitor down low, obviously we can't see it well, but they do have a baseline camera angle that might be the deciding factor. And the officials now discussing it here. And let's see what the call is. They're going to stay with the call, so it will be Western ball. I thought from that angle it wasn't the best angle, but I did think from that angle it looked like Quincy Noble touched
it last.
Had the last
touch. I mean, she's got long fingers, so that's what it looked like. She just had that last little swipe on it. What can you do? I mean, she was blessed tall.
Standing at 5'10", a New Mexico transfer by way of Great McKinney, Texas.
McKinney, Texas.
And so it'll be a baseline inbound here for Western Kentucky. The officials still discussing something up near the wing. I think it's a wet spot they're trying to clear up.
You know, the last season, Zach, it would be like this. You know, the end of the game, the last 2 minutes.
We didn't have a lot of these last year.
30 minutes. The last 36 seconds tonight might be a few minutes long.
So 36.3, they also took a tenth of a second off the clock. 20 on the shot clock, inbound here baseline for Josie Gilvin. Looking for someone to give it to. Gilvin, all the way back up top, reaching for it, almost losing it, but coming away with it was Savory. Outside here, three on the way from Foster, knocks it down with 30.7 to play. And Jaylee Mitchell takes a timeout. It's a six-point game.
Johnson would have just turned her head slightly on that. She could have had the steal on the inbounds play. When you're going to that far player and you have to lob it all the way up there, I mean, she was in the right position to just turn her head and grab that ball. That's kind of when you rely on your teammates, like, Anaya, yo, ball coming your way. You got to talk on defense, have your teammates back.
Western Kentucky has made 14 threes. They have attempted 45 triples tonight. They are, I mean, in one way, it kind of makes sense. If you're going to put up 45 threes and make less than a third of them, that's a lot of points.
No.
They're just a pure volume shooting team, and sometimes it works out for them, and they still have a puncher's chance here, down six with 30 seconds to play.
That's why you have to take care of the ball here. I mean, they're probably going to put the Mean Green on the free throw line here. So you've got to make these shots count, first of all.
Quick inbound to Hardaway, and the foul calls on Foster. She's fouled out. That's her fifth.
And you just can't give the ball away here either. You know, you've got to try to get this rebound if Ariana Hardaway doesn't hit the shot. You just want to keep that ball in your hand.
Hardaway, a dead even 50% free throw shooter. First one is no good. Rolled around the rim and popped out. 28 and a half seconds to play. It's a six-point game, 80 to 74. No good. Rebound taken by Western. 27 seconds to play. They work it into the front court. It's Pitts with it. Pitts outside. Corner. Gilvin with the three. No good. Rebound taken. Shot up. Got it. And the foul for Karis Allen. And a chance at a three-point play as Kendall Magruder gets called for her fourth. And Karis Allen can trim this game down to three with just 17.9 seconds left.
We've got some fans in the
very
arena
vocal
really
fans
trying to coach him up the team.
No good, but an offensive rebound put back, still would not go. Another offensive board still would not land. Bouncing all over the place. Hardaway gets it to Noble, and a timeout taken by North Texas with 10 seconds left to play. Man, Western Kentucky had multiple attempts, and Quincy Noble bails out the Mean Green. Still a four-point game, though, with 10.8 seconds left, and I believe this is the last timeout that the Mean Green have in their pocket. And it's a 30-second timeout.
looked like they all just put lotion on their hands. I mean, Quincy Noble grabbed that ball and just bent right over and said, okay, everyone get away right now. Like, I finally have it, and we're keeping it. 10 seconds left on the clock. You have to take care of the ball here with the way you've been playing. I mean, if the Mean Green did not win this game today, it would not reflect well because they've played so much better than we've seen them play. And you know that they can win this game now.
So 10.8 seconds left. North Texas is out of timeouts. Western still has one. Again, the Mean Green are in the bonus, so any fouls from here on out are going to be free throws for the Mean Green. Ariana Hardaway with a chance to put the game away, missed both free throws, and now let's see who they try and inbound it to. Kendall Magruder looking, finds Carter, and Carter immediately going to be fouled, and that will send her to the free throw line. She's a 54% free throw shooter. 9.6 seconds left, and Aaliyah Pitts was called for the foul, so she is fouled out as well. Two players out of the game for Western, and now Jordan Carter with two huge free throws. She's 2 for 2 today from the stripe. First attempt good, big one there. Makes it a 5-point game.
Really huge for her to make these both. I wanted to say that a second ago, but then I got nervous because, I mean, this arena just went silent, man.
Second attempt. Got it. Two clutch free throws.
All right, and that's
for
what
Carter.
You want. That's what you want right there, man.
Final timeout taken by Western Kentucky with 9.6 seconds to play. It's a 6-point game. You need a 3, a foul, 2 missed free throws, and another 3 if you're Western Kentucky. It looks bleak, but my goodness, when you're 14 of 46 for the day, anything can happen.
Well, and here's the thing. Now neither of these head coaches have any timeouts left, right? So this 9 seconds is the last time you're getting to talk to either of your team, and it could go either way in these 6 seconds, in these 9 seconds, right? You have a team that's shooting really well from the 3-point line. You need to put it into the Mean Green's brain right now. Hey, get in there, play defense. Do not touch anyone, and seal the deal on this ball game.
What a big win this would be for the Mean Green if they can hang on. Timeout moves the ball into the front court for Faustino. She'll inbound it with 9.6 seconds left. Quick inbound poked away by Quincy Noble. That'll drain 1.1 off the clock. It'll still be Western ball with 8.5 to play.
Again, with that reach, I mean, Quincy Noble has those long arms.
Taking full advantage of him in this contest. Faustino looking for somebody, looking, and it's stolen away by Carter, trying to pick it up off the floor, falls over, clock draining though, jump ball, and the possession arrow is with the Mean Green with 4.3 seconds left to play.
And Jordan Carter, like I said earlier tonight, she is that motor. She comes out of nowhere, and that's why she's grown so much on Jaylee Mitchell. You cannot be mad at a kid that hustles after every single ball.
So an inbound here for Kendall Magruder, looking for someone, gets it to Noble. Noble hangs onto it. She's fouled with 2.8 seconds left, and Quincy Noble heads to the free throw line as Hope Savory picks up her second personal. 2.8 seconds left. Quincy Noble can get up to 24 points here on just her second trip to the line today. Good on the first.
Well, when she needs to make him count, she can. That's for sure. Quincy Noble knows how to sink some free throws.
Makes the second one, 84-76. Quick inbound. Clock expires, and the Mean Green hang on to win 84-76. As they improved to 4-9 on the season, 1-2 in conference play. And Anaya Johnson gets a big hug there from Tamisha Lampkin. What a game for her, for the sophomore from Red Oak High School. Anaya Johnson, she'll be our Raising Cane's player of the game, no doubt about that. Double-double with 27 points, 10 rebounds, and 2 blocks. What a win for the Mean Green.
What a win. Like I said earlier, nothing like sleeping in your own bed, nothing like playing in your own house. And it's kind of what these girls needed tonight.
Texas Health post-game show, Texas Health of Denton post-game show is next. 84-76 Mean Green win. This is Mean Green basketball from Learfield.